Joanna. You want to say hello? A, B, C, D. A. A.
A.
B.
C.
C.
D.
D.
I.
I.
O.
O.
B.
B.
I.
I. O. A.
A. C.
A.
E.
B. All right, let me try and add you again. Try to add somebody. All viewers to send you a request to join your broadcast. You can add them. Okay. I'm waiting for someone so I can add this person on the live. All right, so I'm still on the search for the next Choco Millionaire. The criteria is somebody who is brilliant but very needy. It has to be very needy, and the person has to be brilliant. It's just my criteria, forgive me. This is not a discrimination. If you don't fall within the criteria, it's just what my strength can allow for now. I'm still on the search. I'm searching. Feel free to nominate somebody by sending me an email, chocomillionaire@gmail.com. Chocomillionaire@gmail.com. I'm starting with Ghana for now. So those of you outside Ghana, please don't be offended. This is what my strength allows me for now. And I'm hoping it will be a boy and a girl. I don't mind the gender. So far I have one person and I'm still looking for the next person. So the search is on. I have received a couple of inquiries and we are reviewing them. I have a few guys who are helping me to do the review, okay? All right. Let's see. Okay. Ah, thank you. You guys like my African wear, and me and my daughter. Hey, see my daughter. You see what she did do? She's taking off the chassis too. Can you see what she's doing? 22 months. She's already taking it off. I need to go back and straighten that cord well. Huh? This girl. You know you are not allowed to do that. Never take your hands out, okay? Please don't do that, okay? Always check on your case and make sure they are well. She's so slippery, huh? She's so slippery. That Joanna is just so slippery. Don't get your hands out, okay? Very tight. How do you still get your hand out of this thing, Joanna?
Fat lock. Good.
Right. Yesterday I was successful, but not today. I don't know what is happening. guess the connection is not allowing us. So basically, I'm gonna give you a gist. Rania, sorry about that. I may have to upload the video that you've done so far. So just record the video, that way I can share the video with my audience, okay? I'm gonna give you a gist of what we're trying to do here. So I have some few guys on the ground who are assisting me identify the next person. Feel free to send me an email, chacomillionaire@gmail.com. Feel free to nominate somebody that you think. I only have spot for one more person. All right, so it's gonna be a little bit competitive because if you email me, it doesn't mean that automatically you get selected, right? We have to review things and make sure that it is in line with exactly what I want, okay? Brilliant but needy students, and this person must be currently enrolled in either a high school or a tertiary level. A high school or at a tertiary level. I've had a couple of emails, and you must be also from Ghana. Brilliant but needy, currently enrolled in a high school or at a tertiary level. And when we say needy, it simply means that life is so hard that you feel that your educational, your ability to go to school is even threatened, or your ability to be able to live as a student is so hard, right? So basically, these are the people I'm looking for. That was my own situation. That was my own situation when I was in Ghana growing up. It was so hard for me. I got kicked out of an exams hall on the very day of the test in Accra Academy. I used to trek for about 2 hours plus just trying to go to school because there was no transportation. As a day student, I wasn't in a boarding house. I used to go to the canteen begging my colleagues for food just because there was nothing for me. I'm looking for people like this. I said I was going to sponsor 2 people every year. Maybe I might increase that as time goes on, but for now it's just 2 people, right? And I've already found 1 person from the University of Cape Coast. We have started with him already and he's doing great so far. We are looking for the next person, the next Choco Millionaire. Basically the next person with a huge potential, but life is threatening his education. And you must be from Ghana for now. We're gonna expand this to other parts of Africa. For now, my resources are gonna just allow me to focus on the 2 to test and see how it goes, right? There is a follower who is from the Bahamas, somewhere in Canada, but you're from Bahamas. You reach out to me, you love what I'm doing, and you want to see how we can even partner and help more people in Africa. Brilliant, thank you so much. And I know many of you have good hearts, golden hearts. You're looking forward to even assisting in your own way. As time goes on, we might just expand this to allow many more people from other parts of Africa to be able to even come on board and also help support. You know, we are better off as a people if we learn to support and raise each other up. There is a saying that every good climb deserves a push. Every good climb deserves a push. How I understand that is that if you climb tree, or if you are climbing a tree and you climb it good, you deserve to be pushed. You ought to start climbing a tree though. You need to start making moves. You need to start hustling. You need to start trying and hit a corner where there is a wall and you can't, and then somebody can come in and help you out. So I'm encouraging you, even though life is tough, try your best, do your best, and pray that somebody will identify you and give you a push, okay? Don't just sit in a corner and hope that somebody's just going to lift all your burden. You need to always make the first move, praying that God will bring people your way to help you out. The essence of today's interview is that I was basically going to interview my friend Rania, who is part of my team. And we've identified somebody in some part of Accra. And this person, we have been told, somebody nominated him by reaching out to me. And the person said, this person is so brilliant, very young boy, and from a very, very difficult family. He completed his high school in Ghana and had 8 A's. Guys, 8 A's, all A's, in all the 8 subjects. This guy had 8 A's. He wants to be a physician, a doctor, but there is no means. He cannot afford, his parents can't afford his education, and is currently He's not able to start school because they have no money, and he's got 8 A's. And you wonder, like, why don't we have institutions in place ready to support smart, brilliant guys like this? There are many more people. In fact, there are many more people beyond this guy, both ladies and guys, who are out there, brilliant and struggling. Like, guys, it's so hard. When I was in the University of Ghana, in Lagos, life was so hard for me. I wrote a letter, added all kind of proof, and applied to the student financial aid of the University of Ghana. I pleaded for mercy. I said, look, my life is threatened. I want to just go to school. I'm brilliant. Look at my results. I added all kind of proof to show I was poor. But I didn't make it. They didn't give me. It was just a miracle that I was still able to finish school, right? Maybe they didn't have all the resources, or maybe my application wasn't good enough, or maybe I wasn't brilliant enough at that time. But my point here is that as a country, right, we need more institutions and philanthropism where we can actually help people. We need more. We need more of this. So sad that the video connection didn't go through. Maybe I'm going to try when I get up the road in the next 10 minutes or something. But we need a lot of possibilities and allows you to be able to creatively give your best. Education makes you better if you have a talent. Education makes you better if you have a gifted. Education makes you better if you are just half sheer intelligent person. Education harnesses the creativeness, the potential of people. You could be a tailor. With education, you become the next Giorgio Armani, or you become the next Louis Vuitton, or you become the next this. Right? Education brings the best out of people. Education is not just about just book sense. Education makes your thinking, like it enhances your ability to broaden your thinking. And I don't think I'll be here today. So, what do you guys think? drop your comments. Let me know what you think. I'm driving on the highway, but yeah. Very unfortunate that I couldn't release my friend Ryan. He's actually in the house of this gentleman I'm talking about. And we're going to reach out to almost everybody who qualifies and meets our criteria. I've had a few applications where some of you have reached out to me, but you've already finished your university. Unfortunately, you are not eligible. You need to be currently enrolled in a tertiary institution, or you need to be enrolled in a high school, and you need to demonstrate need, that you're desperately in need, okay? So if you have finished your university, unfortunately, I'm not able to sponsor you. If you have gotten an admission to go and do your master's, unfortunately, I'm not able to sponsor you at the moment, maybe in the future. For now, you need to be either in a high school, or you need to be in the university or a polytechnic or a tertiary institution. And you need to demonstrate these two things, that you are brilliant, but you are in desperate need. A brilliant person is somebody who is academically outstanding, is top among his among the top students in his class or his generation or his school, and everybody can see the sheer brightness in this kid. But there is need. There is a need. There is no support. You're struggling to eat. You can't buy food. You're struggling to get an accommodation as a student. You're struggling to buy your books. You're struggling to buy your handouts. You're struggling to pay for your fees. This is what we are looking for. This is what Chaco Millionaire Dream is all about. Trying to get people like this, okay? All right, guys, let me know. My comment section is not moving. The last comment I'm seeing is from Adam Boate, who says, I like your African wear. Let me know if my comment section is working. If it's working, please drop your emojis. Drop your emojis, drop your comments, and let me know it's working, okay? I'm not sure whether my sound is even properly working, okay? I can see some emojis coming, but the comment section is not moving at all. So keep dropping your comments and let me know if it is working. If you can just, Adam Boate, your comment. last year. We've been praying to wear African wear in summer. This is the time that we get to wear African wear, summer. And white people look at it and they marvel at the beauty, the color combinations, right? The intricacies. They wonder, they look at it and they're like, wow, this is beautiful. So in summer, every African is excited to dress in an African print because it makes us stand out. You know, imagine me wearing my kente in the church or my rich Ghanaian fabric. Okay, it's just so beautiful. The white people could just be looking at us all day just because of the color combinations in our fabric, right? So yeah, I enjoy watching. I enjoy wearing the African one. But COVID has messed everything up, huh? Last summer, we know if you enjoy them because COVID. Churches were closed, mosques, all kind of religious institutions, mosques, the temples, everywhere was closed. No gatherings. Ontario is doing so well. Canada in general is doing so well managing the COVID situation. About 80% of the population are now vaccinated. I have taken my first shot. I will be taking my second shot this week, hopefully. I don't even need an appointment. I just have to walk in and go get it done. So we are at a point where the numbers are increasingly going down. That is why they are about to even open the borders for international travel for students, especially. They are going to allow international students to begin coming in for the fall semester. The only guys that they are pretty suspicious about are our neighbors in America. You know, their COVID situation is so unpredictable, right? So Canada is pretty strict about that. Careful not to open the borders yet because, as you know, we are just a small country. 35, 36 million people. It's pretty much the size of the population of California. And so if we mistakenly open the borders and the US COVID situation is not looking good, it simply means they are going to cross the border. And Americans come to Canada easily. Canadians also cross the border easily. So they are watching that. But for now, they are actually planning to have all international students. So if you got your visa, you are able to come into the country, okay? You might be wondering why my church is too far. My church is in about 3 cities away from me. It will take me just 15 minutes to get there. I have actually gotten into the city that I have to come to. In the next 5 minutes, I will be getting off the road and arriving in my church. My church is about 3 different cities away. So whilst we were driving, I was going through city to city and I just arrived in the city. Yeah. And everybody is excited to come to church for the first time today. Yeah. I hope your Sunday has been good, huh? Some of you may have gone to church. Those of you who are not Christians may have done other things. It's all good, whatever you do. Just make sure you have the best of your life. Spend more time with the family on weekend if you're not working. And I try not to work on Sundays at all. I like to spend the Sunday with the family. Yeah. Guys, tomorrow I will be doing a pretty good video. I will be going to an African store in Toronto to go and shop. I'll be going to 2 or 3 different African stores. Now, when I did my video yesterday where I was cooking, many of you were so surprised. How did I get the condo? You had all these questions, huh? Some of you were also worried that that food is plenty. Will I be able to eat all of it? No. We normally make our banku and it's literally everything, guys. Believe me, we literally eat everything you guys eat in Africa here. There are stores where merchants or business people from Africa bring containers worth of African goods, right? So they bring bags of banku flour. These things are already processed. So we don't need to go and ferment the corn dough. We don't need to go and ferment this and that. It's already processed in a bag. So it's like a powder. We just fetch it and put it on fire and mix it with water, and then straightforward, we begin cooking right away. My wife makes kenke. My wife makes banku. She does kokonte. Kokonte in Liberia is called dumboy. So if you are from Liberia, you know what I'm talking about. Dumboy, we make dumboy here. We eat everything you can think of. Topogi, we eat cassava leaf stew. We eat potato grains. These are Liberian dishes. We eat almost pig food. We eat anything, palm butter. We eat palm butter. We eat everything, Liberian dishes. We eat ofa. We eat ofe egusi. We eat amala. We eat chuozafi. We eat everything. Like basically, guys, snail. You know snail, huh? And what? Even snail. But more everything, we eat all of it. Kokako. Lo shala. Benyele lo shala. That stinking fish that we used to prepare food in Ghana. We eat all of it. So don't be surprised. Don't be surprised at all. Here, the African man. Trust that when the African man goes anywhere, he has everything he needs. He has everything he needs. There are stores that sell African stuff. Yes? So you got me right. We enjoy everything. We don't miss out. We don't miss out at all. Don't be surprised. Tomorrow, I'm going to do a live video where I go to the store in Toronto, because it's time for us to shop. Okay, we like to shop for about 3 months, every 3 months or 4 months. We go to an African store in Toronto area there, and then we shop everything we need and we bring it home, and we don't go back until about 4 months. The only things that we shop in my city are things that we cannot get, like African stuff that we can get. So we go to Walmart and we go to other stores. I'm gonna go to the African store tomorrow. So if you want to see how we shop here, and you want to see the prices of goods, huh? Like African stuff, where they sell for Africa. If you want to see how they sell a bag of this, banku flour, tomato paste, African one, Maggi cube, Indomie. If you want to see the prices tomorrow, I'm going to go live and I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to do my groceries in Toronto and you're going to see it. So stay tuned. If you want to watch me tomorrow shop in an African store, stay tuned. I hope you like it. I believe this will even be helpful to you if you are coming. One of the silly mistakes I made when I was coming to Canada was that I packed unnecessary things into my bag. This will be so useful to all of you who are planning to come to Canada, or you may have gotten your visa already. Some of the mistakes I made, yeah, was that I put unnecessary things in my bag. My mom fried meat. Can you imagine that? My mom fried meat, and I had to put it in my bag. Meat. Some people fry fish and put it in their bag. Some people bring gari and put it in their bag. I even made a mistake. Can you imagine, guys? I made a mistake of going to Kantamanto, which is a place in Accra where people basically just buy clothes and stuff like that. It's like your market in Lagos or anywhere, or Tokpa Market in Benin. It's like Tokpa Market in Benin. I went there and I bought winter jackets. Can you imagine that? Huge winter jacket too. I went to buy winter jacket, trying to bring it to Canada. How stupid I was. How do you go to Iboman's country and before you come, you've already bought your winter jacket? When these things are manufactured in the country of the Igbo, it doesn't even make sense if I argue that because of the price. That's why. I just was ignorant. I didn't know. Later on when I bought it, I realized that, look, my bag was so heavy just with the jacket alone. Eventually, I had to give it to somebody for free. I didn't even bring it. What if I knew that these things were cheaper here and I could get them for literally free? But I didn't know. I didn't know. I didn't know. So I have arrived in church. I tried connecting my friend Rania again. But no luck, I have arrived in church, so I'm gonna take my daughter out. Good. Okay, let me lock the car. All right, guys, so here here we are in church, me and my daughter. Hey, say hello. Say hello. Huh? We're going to church. Thank you so much for being with us. Unfortunately, I was not able to do that interview. I wanted to do it whilst I was driving. We're going to bring it to you again. Okay? I love you guys. I'm going to catch you guys soon. God bless you. Remember, you don't need more money. You need more wisdom. Because wisdom is the principal thing in life. Bye-bye. Oh, I need a face mask. Let me go grab my face mask, okay? I just remembered I need a face mask. Got a face mask. Pastor is going to turn me away. Yeah. Without a face mask, I just remembered I need a face mask. Yeah, we still need a face mask to go into the church. Without a face mask, you ain't going to go in there. I need a face mask. Daddy needs a face mask. All right. Wait for Daddy. Here. Can you see my girl looking all smart? Yee. See her? Yee. Don't go far. Daddy's right here. Don't go far. Come. All right, guys. Bye-bye. I'm going to put on my mask. Bye-bye, okay? Okay, let's go. All right, guys. Bye-bye. We love you. Say bye-bye. Bye-bye.